Start to shut up now. Begin shutting your mouths.
All right, everybody, start to shut up. Let's go ahead and wrap up your current sentences and get yourselves to a quiet place.
Everybody, start to shut up.
Let's go ahead and start to shut up.
All right, everyone, shut up and finish shutting up fast.
All right, everyone, start to shut up.
The gross national product that is lost, creativity, imagination of kids in K through 8 in school systems around this country who are not taught as well as they ought to be taught. No fault of the teachers. It's just that it's like a factory. What do we do about this most, in my view, one of the most critical components of this country, the future of these children who are lost in class?
So let's say, first of all, let me agree, no fault of the teachers. Second, certainly no fault of the kids.
Right.
So, you know, I think the old philosopher's trick of imagining a society where, you're born not knowing where you're going to end up, whose family you're going to be in. When it comes to public education, if you're born poor in this country, unfortunately, it's a disaster for you. And we have almost no decent preschool for kids that are living in poverty. We have almost no decent K-12 schools. There are cities and neighborhoods all over America that no senator would send their kid to any of the schools. Yet we're expecting kids to go there and do well. And then, of course, it's really hard for kids to be able to afford college. And there's almost no quality skills training for kids that don't want to go to college. Not just in Washington. Washington can't solve this problem. But all over the country, if we're going to drive the kind of opportunity we need to drive.
Many exciting things. We're going to get things done.
Wow.
We're going to get things done. We're going to get things done. We have things that we're going to get things done.
Wow.
We're going to get things done. Exciting things. People were hopelessly tied up in knots, but you'll see levels of detail. We're going to get things done. You'll see levels of thought. We're going to get things done. Things that nobody has even contemplated, thought about, thought possible. We're going to get things done. So I think we'll start sometime. We're going to get things done.
You were naturally conceived. You're human and you think. You have consciousness, but what about the cells that make up your body? Are they conscious of being part of you?
I think they're programmed to scratch an itch, and they have no knowledge they're part of this bigger thing called atom. Maybe, just maybe, you're just a cell too, Adam. Like, you think you have this whole meaningful life, but in the end, all you really are is a small cell in God's own body. You would think there's a bigger purpose out there. You're not sure what you're supposed to achieve and why, but you multiply and fight to survive just like cells do. And in the end, after all those cells have died, this God will die too. But even he is only a small part of another bigger God that controls more than this planet. Look out there, Adam. Look out there and see how many stars are in the sky. It's infinite. We're just a small cell. And understanding that is what will make you special.
Children are learning to memorize without thinking and obey without questioning. In fact, this established educational system is extremely expensive to keep operational and obsolete in the age of the internet. Why obsolete, you may ask? Because the internet gives us free access to almost infinite amounts of information. So why are we still paying huge amounts of money for governmental education? Because the world's elite require that our children learn conformity and inside-the-box thinking. Mankind's faith is hanging in the balance right now, as the control of the New World Order octopus spreads. On the one hand, we are very close to our complete enslavement, while on the other hand, we could easily crumble to the ground their pyramid of power, by simply uniting against their deception in a peaceful revolution of minds, hearts and souls. We've asked for years what their greatest weapon of enslavement is. Is it poor education combined with constant indoctrination? Is it the fear generated by religion? Is it the fear of being punished, jailed, or killed by the system, Or is it the invisible enslavement of the monetary system? In our opinion, all of the above combined had a huge impact on our society and the way we think, but their biggest weapon is hands down the financial system. The financial system has stealthily enslaved our species, and now we are being used as currency slaves. We all work from 9 to 5 every day, in boring and depressing environments, not stimulated by anything creative or constructive. In most cases, the sole motivation for going to work is the next paycheck, and no matter how hard we work, we never seem to have enough money. Have you ever wondered why mega corporations reaping billions a year in profits pay dozens of millions to their CEOs, and as close as possible to the minimum wage to the rest of the employees? This has been carefully designed, because a person that is constantly on the edge will never have time for self-education, introspection, and eventually, spiritual awakening. Isn't this our main purpose on Earth? To become spiritual beings, and by spiritual, we obviously don't mean religious, and complete the incarnation cycle. They don't need educated people who are capable of critical thinking and have spiritual goals. No, this kind of people are dangerous to the establishment. They want obedient robots, just intelligent enough to operate the machines and keep the system running, but stupid enough never to ask questions. All of the world's biggest problems have their roots deeply embedded in the financial plague. Wars are profitable, diseases are profitable, Earth's plundering is profitable, human slavery and inhumane working conditions are profitable. Our leaders have been corrupted by money, and mankind's collective mission on Earth has been hijacked by money. So why do we need the financial system in the first place? Actually, we don't need it, at least, not anymore. The planet doesn't charge us a cent for using its natural resources, and we have the technology to extract them without physically working a day. More to the point, there are brilliant minds out there discussing the concept of a resource-based economy for decades. One example is Mr. Jack Fresco, a brilliant industrial designer and social engineer, who spent most of his life designing the future. The cities proposed by Mr. Jack Fresco will be built by autonomous construction robots and will be eco-friendly and self-sustainable, earthquake and fireproof. Other people are already discussing the transition plan towards the economy of the future, where money are no longer required, and all individuals will be offered the best conditions to reach their highest potentials, all for the benefit of our species as a whole. So, our question is, are we ready to embrace the future and escape the control of the elite in a world without money? Or are we going to allow the New World Order plan to happen? We are all anonymous by default. United as one. Divided by none. To the rich, greedy, filthy slave creators. You will be removed. Expect that.
I believe that we fractured our space-time dimension into an alternate reality where the collective of self and society has shifted the influence, thus creating the current universe we're in. And let me tell you, bro, it's not a good one.
Ain't that the truth?
They found it. Depth close to 3,230 feet. A deep dive.
Clap your hands, you could probably set a profile. You ain't gotta worry, don't be scary, cause we own now. Ain't no gentrifying us, we finna buy the hotel. Tell the world for shit to suck a dick, cause we own now.